Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT. And in this video, I want to talk to you about content or phase one in your MCAT prep. Not just how to get through content, but also how to evaluate where you are every step of the way so that you can have a clear idea of what you still have to do and how long it's going to take. When it comes to MCAT prep, I have a three-phase approach to make sure that you're ready on test day, where content, that foundation of the material that you have to know, is only the first phase, but it can be the longest and hardest because there's so much to cover. On the MCAT, you will have to go through a year's worth of general chemistry, organic chemistry, biochemistry, many semesters of different topics in biology, as well as psychology and sociology, not to mention cars, which isn't a science, but it's something you want to start practicing from day one. Here's the thing about content. You do not need 100% mastery. Let me say this again. You do not need 100% mastery in the sciences. Let's face it. The average student will get accepted to medical school with a competitive score that's anywhere from just over 500 to the five teens. This means you just need in the upper 120s in the sciences to be okay. Now, I'm not telling you to sabotage yourself and not study enough by aiming low, but most students are fighting the clock, trying to get through content as quickly as possible. And if you think about what it takes to master the information, it will take you longer to go from 90 to 95% mastery than it will to go from 0 to 80. Because 0 to 80, you're learning the basics. Most of it is easy to understand. But 90 to 95 and higher, now you're going into all the tiny little nuances, which your books probably don't cover everything. The videos you're watching probably don't cover everything. And it becomes way too much pressure. Now, before you panic thinking you're going to miss something, remember that phase one is only the foundation. It's only the beginning. When you get to practice passages in phase two, every time you miss something in a passage, you're going to go back and study. So if there's a little detail that you missed because you were only aiming for 90% mastery in phase one, you're going to catch it in practice in phase two and again in phase three, so you're not going to completely miss out. This will help you get the pressure off. This will allow you to move through content quickly enough, but still make sure that you know it. So how do you know when you've done enough? Or more importantly, how do you know that you actually got it? I worked with a student who said she wanted to get through content in 1 month. That was her goal. She insisted that she can get through everything. And in order to do that, she watched videos at 2x speed and sped through her MCAT books. By the time the month was over, she reached her goal. She got through everything. But when she took another full length, she did not see any improvement. Why? Her entire focus was let me get through it, but she didn't stop. She didn't do practice questions. She didn't ask herself, do I know this information? And when she was done, I had to send her back to page one in every subject because she hadn't learned anything. So as you're going through content, first, go with a gut check. How do I feel about this information? Does it make sense? Do I understand it? Is it intuitive enough that if I had to explain it to someone else, they would understand what I'm teaching them? Don't focus on regurgitation. Not talking memorization, I'm talking about logic of what the heck is going on. Memorization should happen separately. Dedicate time every single day to active writing, which I explain in the link below, so that you slowly but surely commit the facts to memory, but keep the facts separate from the concepts when you study, so that you're not so overwhelmed trying to memorize that you're not actually paying attention. Gut feelings will only get you so far. We want numerical data to back it up, and that's where practice questions come in. If you're studying from an MCAT book, you will see questions in and at the end of the chapter. Do not skip these questions. Take the quiz and evaluate how you did. Did you hit at least 70% correct? If you score less than 70%, you haven't mastered the information. It's okay. It's better to know that now than when you finish and have to restudy everything. If you hit less than 70%, go back and restudy the chapter, making sure that you really and truly get it. The ideal score is between 70 and 90% of the questions correct. But that doesn't mean you're good, move on. You still want to go through every question and understand, what did I get wrong? Why did I miss it? What am I not yet understanding that I need to go back and review? And if you consistently score above a 90% correct, well, first of all, congratulations, but you're probably going too slow. Not what you expected to hear, I'm sure. But again, the amount of effort it takes to master between 90 and 95% is so high that if you allow yourself to go a little bit faster on the next chapter, sacrificing just a small fraction of what you can learn, that time will be better spent allowing you to get through the next chapter more quickly. Again, this assumes you're racing the clock. If you like the pace that you're going and you want to be scoring 95% or higher, by all means, right? The more you know, the better. Are you racing the clock? Well, let's see. How much time did you set aside for phase one, and how long is it going to take you to finish? So let's break out the trusty calculator and see how to evaluate your phase one timeline. The first thing we have to know is your starting point from today for every single subject. Specifically, we're looking to see what you've already studied for the MCAT, and we're not counting any classes that you've taken. If you took physics and you got an A in physics 1 and physics 2, great! You're going to have a much easier time restudying physics for the MCAT, but if you haven't started yet, that's still 0%. Let's back it up. If you're starting fresh, either because you're just starting to study, or because you're giving yourself a clean slate and starting over, just put 0% for every subject and start tracking from today. If you've already been studying, but you don't know exactly where you are, let's first figure out your starting point. I like to use MCAT books, but you can use your books, your videos, the AMC outline, whatever you want, so long as you're consistent. What we want to do for every subject is figure out the number of pages or videos or whatever measurement you've completed, divided by the total number available. This will give us a fraction, so we multiply by 100 to turn the answer into a percent for percent progress. Let's say you got to topic 4.3 monosaccharides, which is on page 113 in the 2015 MCAT Kaplan Biochemistry Review Book. This means that you have completed 112 pages divided by 431 pages, which is the last page of content explanation before the glossary. Punching this into the calculator, I have 112 divided by 431, which equals to 0.2598, and the numbers keep going, honestly, don't care. We just want to have two numbers, that's it. We then multiply by 100% using the decimal trick that I teach in the MCAT Math series linked below, which gives me 25.98 or 26%, and this would be specifically for the biochemistry review book. As another example, let's say you're working through the Exam Cracker physics book from 2015 and completed up to page 109, Waves, Sound, and Light. This means you have 108 pages completed, divided by 229 pages, omitting the last few that have photo credits and whatnot. Punching this into the calculator, we get 108 divided by 229, which is equal to 0.47161 dot dot dot, way too many numbers, let's take the first two, apply the decimal trick, which gives us 47.1, or simply 47% through MCAT physics. Do this for every subject so that you know exactly where you're starting. The next thing we want is to understand your weekly percent progress. You want to know if your studying is consistent, how much do you get done in a given week, and based on that, how long is it going to take you to complete? Continuing with the example above, let's say you did this for every subject, and you realized that you are at 20% average progress. This is because some subjects are faster, some are slower, but you just added them all up, divided by the total number, and that gave you the average. Then you look back to the last 2 weeks, and you ask yourself, have I been consistent with my weekly studying? If you haven't, then it's not fair to judge based on that. If you spent most of the last 2 weeks partying, hanging out with friends, or binging Netflix, we're not going to count that. Instead, I want you to use today as a clean slate, start fresh, study the way you hope to study every week moving forward,
and see what you come up with. Let's estimate that with week one solid progress, you manage to hit an average of 4.7%. And with week two of consistent studying, you hit an average of 5.3%. The two numbers are pretty close, which is amazing. So first, ask yourself, what did I do the second week that let me go faster than the first week? Because if you improved your studies and you can continue to improve, that would be even faster than we're going to estimate. But for the sake of this example, I'm going to take the average of the two, which is conveniently 5% a week, and use that to figure out progress. So first, how much do we still have to do? Well, we had 20% average from evaluating what you've already done. We added another 4.7 and 5.3 for 10% in the 2 weeks that we were evaluating. That means right now you're sitting at 30% total progress with an average expected increase of 5% per week. With 100% representing completion of all of the sciences, minus the 30% that you've already done, tells us that you have 70% to go. If you have 70% to go, divide that by 5% per week, which is what you estimate that you can realistically complete. Punch that into the calculator. 70 divided by 5 tells you 14. 14 weeks is the estimate to complete content, but that doesn't include a buffer. So as you're figuring out your timeline, ask yourself, can I afford to add in maybe 1 or 2 weeks as a buffer so that if something comes up, like a birthday or holiday, if you get sick, right? No one plans to get sick. Or if your family from out of town surprises you, it doesn't completely derail your schedule. It simply eats up the buffer that you've already built in. Most students who calculate this tend not to be happy with this number. But it's better to figure this out now when you can still make a change than to realize a week before your MCAT, uh-oh, I'm not ready. If you're happy with your results, great. Work very hard every week, but don't stop there. Ask yourself, how can I do even better next week? But if you're not happy with the results because you were hoping to finish faster, I want you to figure out what it's going to take. In our example, we had 70% still to go and a 14-week timeline. Let's say you're looking at your calendar and you're thinking, I can't afford 14 weeks. I want to finish in 9 weeks. What's that going to look like? Take the total that you still have to complete, divide it by the ideal number of weeks, and this is going to give you your new weekly target percent progress. This is going to tell you how much progress you have to make to stay on track with your faster goal. If we have a target of 70%, looking to complete that in a total of 9 weeks, that's 70 divided by 9, which is equal to 7.77 or 7.8. That means your new weekly progress is 7.8% per week. What does that actually look like? Keep in mind, you're going to move faster in some subjects or slower in the other. But for the sake of our example, how many more pages per week do you have to complete? In our Kaplan Biochem book with 431 pages, to figure this out, you want to take the total number of pages and multiply that by your weekly percent target. Remember to turn your target back into a decimal, which means you take your percent and you divide it by 100. Going back to our Kaplan Biochem example, if we had 431 pages total and we want to complete 7.8% per week, we do 431 times 0.078 or 431 times 7.8% divided by 100. This comes to a weekly goal of 33.6 and change, which we're going to round up to 34 pages. Just so you understand the difference, at 5%, we were looking at 431 times 5 divided by 100 or times 0.05, which was only about 22 pages per week. Look at the difference and ask yourself, is this number realistic? Looking back at exam cracker physics with 229 pages, first, let's see what 5% per week gave us. So we do 229 times 5 over 100 or 0.05, which gives us 11.45 or 12 pages per week. Notice that I'm always rounding up. There are going to be days where the content is really difficult and the going is slow. So if you're aiming for a higher number of pages, you build in that buffer for when the going gets tough. At 5%, you were completing 12 pages a week, but now that you're looking to bump it up to 7.8%, we're looking at 229 times 7.8 divided by 100, or 0.078. This comes to 17.86, or 18 pages per week. Again, ask yourself the difference between 18 and 12. Is that something doable and realistic? Excellent. Let me see what it's going to take to hit that new number. Once you're about 70% through content, you're ready to start mapping out a detailed timeline for phase two, meaning when you're going to take your full lengths and how you're hoping to score.
Before you run to get your books and see how much you've already covered, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on any new videos. Then, let me know in the comments below how much time you were initially thinking to allot for phase one, and what your timeline looks like having run through this math. If you need help with the rest of the MCAT process because you're overwhelmed by all the conflicting information available online, visit my website, layerforsci.com/ultimate, to check out my ultimate guide to MCAT prep and download the free companion workbook to make sure that you're always on track.